Wherever there is river blindness, there is the Mectizan donation program and its partners. Governments, agencies, NGOs, and countless individuals dedicated to the same objective: control and elimination of a centuries-old scourge. 25 years ago, such an ambitious goal would have seemed like nothing more than a dream. But that's changed with a combination of scientific discovery, visionary leadership, and extraordinary commitment. River blindness, which is also known as onchopsychiasis, is one of the world's leading causes of preventable blindness. The World Health Organization estimates there are more than 100 million people at risk, with 37 million infected, 800,000 visually impaired, and 270,000 blind. And millions more silently suffering from unbearable itching. For centuries, the disease plagued remote communities in Africa, Latin America, and the Middle East. There was no answer to the affliction, which is caused by the bite of infected black flies which breed in fast-flowing rivers. Those flies deposit parasitic filarial worms which can migrate to the eye, where they die, resulting in severe inflammation and scarring that can lead to impaired vision and blindness. In the Central African Republic, Michel had dreams of working in the health sector, but he gradually went blind and was cast out by his family. His cousin Jacques took Michel in, where he's lived ever since. The younger generation hasn't suffered the same fate. But in 1975, Dr. William Campbell of Merck Research Laboratories suggested that the company's veterinary drug, ivermectin, could potentially kill juvenile parasites in humans. Campbell and colleague Dr. Mohamed Aziz felt it could treat river blindness. After years of further research and human trials, followed by swift regulatory approval in Europe, came the big moment. In 1987, Merck's CEO, Dr. Roy Vagelis, made a bold pledge.
At that meeting, we announced that Merck would contribute the drug free to anyone in the world who needed it for as long as it was needed.
Vagelis had no idea how big the program would get. 25 years, over 1 billion treatments, in more than 117,000 communities. The program has set a new standard. It's become the longest-running drug donation in history.
I think Roy Vagelos and his colleagues understood that this was a unique situation where we had in our hands a very powerful medicine, in effect, a way of preventing this kind of blindness, which itself is totally preventable, from afflicting generations of people in the areas of the world that could least afford it.
In order to turn the pledge into practice, Merck created an entirely new organization, the Mectizan Donation Program, which is based at the Task Force for Global Health in Atlanta. Their mission? To assess needs and requests from governments, agencies, and NGOs, order the drugs, shepherd smooth implementation, assess the outcomes, and manage essential partnerships. MDP is the funnel through which everything flows. From there, new seeds were quickly sown and more organizations sprung up.
It has created the Africa program for onchopsychiasis control. It's created the Americas program, the AWEPA program, which would never have happened. And even, you know, we talk a lot about community-directed interventions. If there hadn't been APOC, there would not have been community-directed intervention, at least not as they are now, not as far developed, because these were developments that were needed to try and make the whole program sustainable.
The community-directed approach has been one of the most innovative and successful initiatives under the program. It decentralizes much of the responsibility for mobilization and drug distribution and places it in the hands of the communities themselves.
We have seen really that by engaging the people, the treatment coverage increased significantly.
It's very, very gratifying. It's very, very empowering for everyone, not just the people there, but for the international community to recognize that this doesn't have to be a paternalistic effort. It should be one of partnership where everyone from the very bottom to the very top can be engaged.
The government ministries and NGOs still play a crucial role, facilitating drug transportation and training, but they and other health programs are taking note.
This is going to be a legacy that this program is going to leave behind once we're able to finish with all the elimination, because these people are highly trained to go into the community and establish any kind of public health intervention in those communities.
And indeed, in 1998, the program itself embraced another public health intervention, which represented another breakthrough. It was discovered that Mectazan, when taken with the drug albendazole, donated by GlaxoSmithKline, can help prevent lymphatic filariasis. Caused by parasitic worms that disrupt lymphatic vessels, LF is a horribly disfiguring condition that causes severe swelling of the limbs and genitals. Estimates put the number of people infected at more than 120 million, 44 million with symptoms. When infected, quality of life suffers enormously, but distribution campaigns in both urban and rural areas can make a tremendous difference with prevention.
You can reduce the level of infection within that community to such a low level that the mosquito can no longer effectively transmit new disease to new people. So you're not curing those who have already been infected. They will still have their swollen limbs and they still need care. But you can break the transmission and stop new people from becoming infected.
None of this would be possible without dedicated partners in the private and public sectors and legions of helpers in the communities themselves.
I would say that for all of us back here, we should take a great life's lesson from this collection of humane, rational, enlightened people who are so committed, so dedicated, that they are out there day after day facing all kinds of personal hardships and dangers to ensure that this medicine can be delivered to the people who need it.
Merck's pledge and visionary idea to donate all the Mectazan that is needed for as long as it takes to defeat river blindness has had a tremendous impact. Transmission is thought to be interrupted or eliminated in four of the six endemic countries in the Americas, with Africa and the Middle East making significant progress. Now, thanks to the work of the partners who've been committed for decades, younger generations are able to work, play, and enjoy life without the specter of river blindness or lymphatic filariasis. They can be more productive, provide for their families, and live happier lives. They can apply the lessons learned to other health campaigns, leaving a lasting legacy of a program that has combined broad, innovative thinking with local knowledge, courage, and determination.
Many years of hard work.